So now we will see an overview of the GUI of JMeter. So let me start my JMeter, and it is already started. We have started our JMeter in the last session, and this is our JMeter running here. Let me increase the window size so you can see everything clearly. And this is now our JMeter here. And now you will see four sections here. The first section is the menu bar, which is at the top here. Then we have the main toolbar, which is this section, and then here you will see the test plan and all the elements of a test plan in a tree view. And then this is a section, this is the editor section, where you will see the editor window for whatever element you select here in the tree view. And then here is are the options for time, logs and users. I will show you everything. So let us start with the menu. So you can see at the top we have file, edit, search, run, option, tools and help. If I go to file, here we have these options to create a new test plan. We can go from here or to select from a template or open any test plan from your system, open the recent test plans, merge, save, save test plan as and save selection, save as test fragment or restart JMeter. Now, if I go to file again and here if I go to templates, here it will open the templates window and you can use these templates as sample projects. For example, if you want to start or create a web test plan, you can select build a web test plan from here. And if I say create here, I will not save the earlier test plan. Let me just create this one. You can see here it has created a template for a web test plan which has all the basic elements required for a web test plan. Now I'm going to show you all this from scratch in the coming sessions, but it will be a good practice to start with a template. Then again, if I go to file, we have all these other options here. Let me go to edit, and here we have options to add, and this is where we can start adding our assertions, timers, preprocessors, config elements, listeners and everything. And we will see this in detail in the coming sessions. We have options to insert parent, cut, copy, paste, duplicate, remove, save selection as, save as test fragment and all these options here. We also have a help option here. And if I go to edit and if I go to help, this will take me to the documentation page where you can see help for that particular element that is selected. For example, if you see here, as of now I had selected an element which is an HTTP request, and as I went to edit and went to help, it opened the documentation for HTTP request. Let me select view results tree here, and again I will say edit and go to help, and now this time you will see it will take me to the view results tree documentation. So this will be very handy and helpful. And now if I go to the option search, here we have search and reset search options. If I go to run menu, here we have start, start no pauses, remote start when you have remote nodes attached. You can also do remote start from here, remote start all, stop, shutdown and exit options here. And then some of these options are also available in the main toolbar, and I will show you this in a moment. Then we have options menu, and here you can change the look and feel of JMeter. If you want a light theme or dark theme or any of these, you can select from here. Then we have a log viewer, so it will show you the logs, and we also have the log viewer button here. So this is the button. If I select this, it will show me the logs. If I select it again, it will hide. So as of now, it is showing me the logs here. If I press again, it will hide, and the same option you can get from the log viewer here. Then we have log levels, and by default it is at information level, but in case you are doing any debugging, you can always change this to a trace, debug, all, and then see all the logs. We have SSL manager. In case you are dealing with any application that requires SSL certificate, you can select the certificate from your system. Then we have option to choose language. If you want to change language of JMeter, can choose from here. We have collapse all and expand all, and then zoom in, zoom out. And then you can also see collapse and expand buttons here as well. Then we have tools. Here we have an option to create a heap dump and thread dump, so it will save a log file. If I select this, you can see it has saved this dump into this log file. And then we have function helper dialog, which will open this function helper where you can select and create functions. I will show you this later. We also have function helper dialog here, so you can see on the main toolbar. This will take you to the same window. And then we have all these generate HTML reports option, compile options, export and generate schematic view options, and import from CURL. Then we have help, and here if I go to help, it will take you to the documentation page of JMeter, where you can see all these help options and all the documentation. I will go back and go to help menu, and we have all these options, enable and disable debug. We have useful links. It will take you to release notes if you want to create an issue, or you want to go to the component reference documentation. It will take you all to the documentation page. And then we have a link or an option of about JMeter. This will show you your JMeter and its version. So this was the top menu. And then we have this main toolbar, and some of the options which are very frequently used are provided here in the main toolbar. So here you can see all these options. We can start with new. This is to create a new test plan. Then a template. It will open the template window as we have seen earlier. Then here is the option to open a file or a test plan from your system. We have save, then cut, copy, paste, expand and collapse. Then this is a toggle switch. Then we have run or start and start without pauses. Here you will see a button for stop, and then here is a button for shutdown. Now the difference here is, if you are running a test plan and you want to stop everything abruptly, you can select stop here. And if you want the test to stop gradually, gracefully, after stopping all the active threads, you can select shutdown, and these will become active when a test plan is running. Then again we have clear and clear all. When we have listeners or results element, report elements in JMeter, if you want to select a report element or a listener and want to clear it, you can use clear. And if you want to clear all the data from all the listeners, we use clear all. Again, I will show you this in detail. Then we have search option, we have reset search. This is function helper dialog, and this will take you to the documentation. Now coming to this side of JMeter, here you will see the time. So when you run a test plan, you will see the time elapsed here. This is to view the logs, as I have already shown you. This will show you the logs at the bottom and then hide the logs. And here, this is for viewing the number of active users. So as you start your test plan and you have multiple users, you can see this count increasing as the users get added to your test plan. Now coming to here, here you will see all your test plan and all its components. So as of now, you can see this is a test plan, and then here you can see a thread group, and then these HTTP request defaults and all these elements. And here is the editor. So whatever element I select here, its editor will open here. Now if I want to rename any page, or if I want to rename any element, for example, instead of home page, I say my page here, you can do that. And if you see, as of now, it is still showing home page here. If I select anything outside or click outside, now this is changed to my page. So you can do that. And this is all about the GUI overview of JMeter. I hope this was useful. Thank you for watching.